treasures then?
You don't think in heaven that's what they're gonna have? They're gonna be fixed?
Yeah, their pleasures will be determined.
Like it's gonna be predetermined.
Their pleasures and desires.
So you can't, for example, be a paedophile in heaven, no.
But you're not going to be the same person.
No, not really. You're going to have different
desires. So give me an example. Then you have like these 20, 70 versions of them, right? Maybe that's not going to be such a heavenly... Oh. That's more like an airplane pleasure, isn't it?
No. Yeah, but that one, there's continuities and discontinuities, isn't it?
Such as?
Continuities like sexual pleasures will remain, but the only the ones which are compliant.
The same sex.
I'm not surprised,
by the way. Yeah. For what?
Enjoyment.
For enjoyment.
What's again?
For enjoyment.
Which one?
Not having
babies. No.
Is that sufficient for you, for a heaven?
Yes. So you've got everything else as well, not just that. You have lots of things.
Which is what?
You have everything you want.
Well, that's a very earthly image of what it's supposed to be.
Not really. The hadith says that. You'll see
so,
things
so
and...
So you're going to retain your physical body as you are now?
No, it'll be different.
How will it be different?
It'll be different, it'll be reconstructed. In hell, the human body's going to be
in
like...
In what shape? In what form?
I don't know exactly what form.
But when you say sex, you're suggesting you're going to have sex as a... especially a virgin.
Everything is different, even the way you go to the toilet. You don't go to the toilet. The respiratory system is going to be different. The digestive tract is going to be different. The physiology is going to be different. Your needs are going to be different.
But why
your age is going to be different.
Why would ethics or morality continue to exist?
Only those which are compliant with Islam.
But why would it? Because you suggest that there could be a morality that could fail someone's opinion. Are you going to be with your parents? Are you going to be alone in heaven?
Basically,
are you going to be alone in heaven, or are you going to be in a society?
No, you won't be alone.
If you're not going to be alone, you're going to have opinions.
Well, let me tell you something. The Prophet told us about heaven, and this is the underlying principle. Yeah, it's ما خطر على قلب بشر. It's something that no human being has been able to, or no heart has been able to experience. Therefore, speculating about the unseen is like throwing rocks in a dark room.
You're not speculating, you're saying that morality...
What I'm saying is that in heaven, there's certain emotions, there's certain tendencies, certain temperaments, which will not exist there, which exist here.
Okay, but you're, is that going to be influenced by God, or is that going to be a self...
As you go into heaven, just like there are laws of physics which govern your transactions in the universe, there will be laws of physics or nature, you could say, that will govern what you do, what you feel, how you think, what you, etc. in heaven. Yeah.
Are you going to continue to be an individual?
You'll continue to be an individual.
So therefore,
yes.
There will be some. And as long as you're not alone, you're going to have others. They're going to have different ventures. They're going to be interested in doing different things. Agree?
That's true. But
so you're
within,
have,
let me
so
tell you
going
something.
To have opinions. And therefore, if that morality continues to exist, people are going to have an opinion of you not being...
The difference between heaven, the afterlife, and the dunya is as follows. The dunya is a test. So the Quran says, وَلَقَدَ خَلَقَنَا الْإِنسَانِ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. We have created the human being, and we know what his self whispers to itself. In other words, we know that the human being has two things. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَهَا. He's got the tendency or propensity to do good, and the propensity or inclination to do evil. That's our state in the dunya, in the world. Whereas our state in the hereafter, whether it be heaven or hell, will be a state of constant remembrance of God. And I'll tell you why. There's an interesting similarity between...
But you're going to be... conversing to pleasure too.
Let me tell you. Let me just tell you what I'm talking about. Whether you're in heaven or you're in hell, you'll be forced to think about and to glorify God. Let me say that one more time. Whether you're in heaven or whether you're in hell, you'll be forced to glorify God.
When you
hell,
say forced,
yes.
Self-will or it's physical?
No, it's going to be all of the conditions, the environmental factors will push you towards that. For instance, if you're drowning in the sea, you're forced to gasp for air, for example, if you have the chance to. The environmental factors force human beings to do something. The difference between heaven and hell is often highlighted, but there is this interesting similarity between heaven and hell. Heaven and hell conceptually is a place or places where you're forced to think about God. Where heaven, human beings do so voluntarily because of the bounties that have been given. In hell,
there is free will in heaven as well.
There is free will everywhere. Even in hell, there'll be free will. But the environmental factors that's going to surround the human being will only enable the human being to do dhikr and or remembrance of God and ask Allah for help. That's all it's going to be.
You're suggesting that there will continue to be free will in heaven, right?
Yes.
And you're going to continue to be able to do things in a society where there will be opinion of others to the point where there could be conflicts.
That's
for
the point.
Example, someone having sex with 72 virgins, it's not really exciting.
Let me tell you something, you're not understanding this one more time. Heaven, according to the Quran, it says, وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. We have taken from their hearts every resentment before they go into heaven, wherein rivers lie beneath. The point being is that heaven, the structures of heaven, are completely different from the structures of the dunya, of this world. Therefore, what you want to do, what you think, how you feel, your emotions, your physiology, your biology, all of these things will be geared towards a different direction. Even your body will be different. Even your body will be different. There's a hadith that, for example, when it talks about hell, that say a tooth of a person will be the size of a mountain. The human being, the body of the human being in hellfire will be so big that the tooth is going to be as big as a mountain.
Are you suggesting that the basis of the heart, how we deem morally what's right and wrong, that will be completely different in heaven? So for example, when we talk about pedophilia, how we think it's wrong, in heaven...
No, what I'm saying is, let me put it in one sentence.
Thank you, appreciate that.
Let me put it in one sentence. What's your name again?
Alex,
one sentence. In heaven, you will have no desire to do haram, prohibited actions.
What? Aye, that's one of the requirements.
Listen carefully.
Okay, that's fine.
Can you have a desire to do something which you have no availability to and which you have no experience of?
But you're making a predefined pleasure.
Let me ask you a question, right? Here in this world that we live in, can you be addicted to drugs?
Yes.
Yes. Can you be addicted to alcohol?
Yes.
Yes. But if you don't know anything about drugs and you don't know anything about alcohol, you cannot be addicted to something because you have no experience of it.
No, of course. But
now, imagine we're in a world with no drugs and no alcohol, whatever, yeah? That's a world where you cannot be, not only can you not be addicted to it, but you cannot consume it. Heaven is a place where the availability and the experience of such a thing as, for example, drugs or same-sex intercourse will be a non-factor. So because it will be taken away.
Are you no longer the same soul? Are you no longer the same entity? Or somehow God just decided to fix it?
It depends. The same entity, no, because your physical structure will be rearranged.
But it's ultimately the soul or the non-physical that drives you even in this world.
That's right, but there are things that, in addition to the soul, from an Islamic perspective, which also drive you. So for instance, classically, Islamically, there's usually, except for Ibn Taymiyyah's opinion, but most scholars differentiate between the self and the soul. So the self is different from the ruh. Nafs is different from the ruh.
Ruh is just a ghost, right?
The ruh is the soul, right? And the self is the nafs. Now, there's those two things, but you also have jasad, the body. You also have the qalb, the heart. So all of these things, in the context of the dunya, motivate our actions. Whereas in heaven and hell, the arrangement will be different. The only thing which will be intact is your soul. Now, everything else, you could argue the nafs will also be intact, but certainly the body will not be the same in heaven and or hell. So
the same soul, right?
The same soul.
You're gonna remember your.
But the desires, look, the desires are not composed of just the soul, because the Quran says if we differentiate between the soul and the self, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ. We have certainly created the human being. وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ. And we know exactly what his self whispers to him. In other words, the human being's desires are as a result of his self interacting with the external environment, the extraneous variables. Whereas in heaven, The self will be, if we accept this, not the same. The body will not be the same. Everything will be altered.
But the fact that you say morality and ethics continues to exist suggests that there is going to be a standard, a prevailing standard to adhere to.
What I'm saying is that...
How could that be in heaven?
What I'm saying is that in heaven, we have to understand that the point of demarcation between heaven...
Before you go there...
Sorry, yeah.
Do you accept that and you really think that ethics continue to exist?
Yes, but the implementation of ethics, as is known in the dunya, will be rearranged in the heaven. But let me tell you what I'm talking about.